Now, finally, one more position that we worked this lower leg action in. And that is standing with most of your body weight on one leg. So we did standing before with the legs together. This time we'll put the easy foot in front, excuse me, pilgrim, and bend both knees, and then roll through just that easy foot. Yes, breathing in and breathing out. Slowing down the movement, taking your time. And once you've warmed up this side, you can begin to lighten the leg that's behind. This is going to be the most challenging of all the options that we've discussed so far in these little videos. So your back toe can stay on the ground. It does not have to float up. Your front knee stays a little bit bent, and you might not feel as much lift and lower through the ball of the foot and the heel of the foot. That's okay. Make sure the joints feel good and your breath is steady. And after you've begun to feel some of that work in the easier leg, we'll switch to the more challenging one. Again, the back foot does not have to come off of the floor. The toe can stay down. You're already putting lots of your body weight into that front leg, keeping a little bend in the knee, at least unlocked. And then begin to roll. And as you breathe, feel what it's like to wake up this side. Just your strain-free range of motion. Back foot can stay on the floor, or it can start to float up whenever you like. Either way, this front leg is the one that's doing almost all the work. I should say too, your spine is still pretty neutral in all of these variations we've been doing. We're not looking to round the spine into cat. Keep it neutral. And then maybe end with that one last slow one. The slowest movement so far. Now make sure that if you're trying this final variation that's the most challenging one, you've warmed up with at least one of the other ones, maybe even two of the other ones, before you try this one-legged standing variation. Mm-hmm.